let me stay right there a little bit longer. Underneath the stars, we are on fire. And I don't wanna go, if you don't wanna go. We can just stay here in this minute, lose all track of time. Let the world be known without us for a while. I'm telling you, we're just one kiss away from heaven. So baby, hold on tight, 'cause I want to get wrapped up in your love. So baby, let's just stay here tonight. Tonight, I just wanna linger like this.
From dawn to dusk in the red dirt heat, busting it up for a couple of bucks. But it ain't no thing, just another day till I'm on my way to them cool, cool sheets. And you and me working on the night shift, baby.
Hello.
Okay. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Jake Shriver, and I'm proud to represent and honor the class of 2019 graduates and our friends, family, and faculty at our graduation ceremony. Would you please pray with me at this time? Dear God, at a moment many of us have been waiting for has arrived. Lord, I pray that each and every one of us find your comfort and love in a time where our lives will be changing dramatically. Let us give glory to you in everything that we do, say, and think. I pray thanks for all the family and friends that are here with us tonight. I pray safety over all of our military and those fighting so that we can have freedom to gather like this. As change is on its way for Brock High School, I pray that all the teachers and administrators will follow in your wisdom and light. Guide and watch over all of us on our journeys home and through life. It's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Thank you, Jake. Good evening. My name is Bobby Atchley, and it is my privilege and honor to serve as principal of Brock High School. I would also like to welcome everyone as we celebrate the accomplishments of this great senior class of 2019. At this time, I would like to introduce the salutatorian of the senior class of 2019. Miss Emily Metzler is the daughter of Steve and Stacy Metzler. Emily will be attending Texas A&M University next fall, majoring in mechanical and biomedical engineering. Please welcome Emily Metzler.
Thank you, Mr. Atchley. Administration, teachers, staff, friends, family, and fellow students, it is my honor to be here before you today. To be honest with you, I had no idea what my speech was supposed to look like, so I did what all good high school students do, and I went to YouTube for some help. Most speeches I found were long and annoying, so I'll make mine brief. One of the best speeches I found talked about how the most important things in our lives get summed up in a little dash between two dates of importance. Our dash began on August 24th, 2015, as we walked between those doors to start our freshman year at Brock High School. It ends tonight, May 24th, 2019, as we walk across this stage, receiving our diplomas. All of our hard work, dedication, preparation, practice, and self-discipline gets little more than a few drops of ink on a page. It's an interesting thought that the most important memories of our lives gets crammed up into that little dash. We've grown up with each other. We've made countless memories together. We've laughed, cried, loved and lost, and in the end, we're all the better for it. After all, we wouldn't be the people we are today if our past were altered in some form or fashion. Over the past 4 years, I've learned many things, one of the most important being holding firm in my values and beliefs. Many things challenge us in life, but as long as you stay true to your values, like a compass pointing north, our lives will pan out in the ways we wish for them to go. As I look around this room, I see future nurses, doctors, teachers, engineers, and so much more, who are ready for their next chapter in life. I'd like to take a moment now to thank everyone for coming tonight to celebrate this milestone with us. To all those involved in making this evening amazing, thank you. To my parents and family, thank you for supporting me and for helping me shape my future. To all parents and families, thank you for taking us to practices, games, summer camps, sleepovers, and supporting us in all that we do. To my band directors who have given me the opportunity to become a leader, thank you. And finally, on behalf of the class of 2019, I'd like to thank the administration and staff who have helped us throughout these past 4 years. Now class, just remember to keep your compass pointed north, stay true to your values, and in the wise words of J.R.R. Tolkien, not all those who wander are lost.
Thank you, Emily. It is now my pleasure to introduce the valedictorian of the senior class of 2019. Mr. Luke Hamilton is the son of Todd and Mina Hamilton. Luke will be attending Texas Christian University next fall with a major in biology, a minor in chemistry, and all focused on the pre-med track. Please welcome Luke Hamilton.
Good evening, faculty, friends, family, and fellow classmates. Faculty, thank you for all of the hard work you put in every single day. We all appreciate your unceasing love, dedication, and drive to make our high school experience the best it can possibly be. Friends, thank you for all of the support you've given me the past 4 years. High school would have been so much harder without you, and I owe you all the love for that. Family, thank you for always praying for me and supporting me in everything I do. You guys are the backbone of this journey, and I can't even describe how appreciative I am of you. Fellow classmates, how is this night already here? It seems like just yesterday that we were all reading the 0.5 picture books to get the most AR points in elementary school, planking to our desks in Coach Chalsh's 6th grade PE class, and even getting bottle flips, chicken-y cups, and blankets banned from BHS. These past 4 years have flown by, and I'm honestly so, so proud of this class. In 2015, we arrived at Brock High School, overly excited to start the next 4 years of our lives. We were ready to walk the halls of BHS, to start competing in varsity sports, to become involved in a wider variety of extracurricular activities, and most importantly, to have the opportunity to leave campus during lunch so that we can go eat with friends, or even on occasion take a solid 40-minute nap during the lunch break. However, we soon realized that high school was not the perfect luxury we once presumed it to be. High school made us go through immense amounts of academic pressure, tension, and stress. Thank you for that, Ms. Wilcox and Coach Morales. We all really appreciate it. Yet, through all of this, the 2019 graduating class of Brock High School without a doubt left its mark on BHS. We have been an influential part of 2, soon to be 3, Lone Star Cup titles, the first Brock football team to win state in 2015, a golf state championship in 2016, the first UIL academic team from Brock to take 14 students to the state meet in Austin, and so many other state titles and appearances in basketball, football, archery, tennis, golf, cross country, track, softball, baseball, UIL academics, and arts. This class has accomplished a lot. However, we go much beyond the accomplishments seen on the surface. We signify and embody the true meaning of strength and unity. But don't worry, I won't stand here and list off the countless definitions of these terms, as you would expect, but I will stand here and explain how this class has done so. On July 3rd, 2015, we lost a fellow classmate, Clayton Anderson. Clayton was a light in this world. He showed us all how to keep a smile on our face 24/7. I ran cross country with Clayton in 7th and 8th grade, and I was always inspired by his continuous enthusiasm and passion for the sport and everything else he put his mind to. I truly believe that Clayton brought the class of 2019 closer together. And he has taught us all so much about ourselves and the world. As we move into this next chapter of our lives, it is essential that we are always there for each other because we don't know what internal battles people are facing. It is imperative that we encourage each other to get up, push on, and keep pressing even through the valleys of life. This begins with the 3 traits that I'm here to talk to you about today: continuous passion, continuous belief, and continuous integrity. These traits have taught me so much about myself and the world that surrounds me. They have allowed me to open up and grow in all aspects of my life while still remaining true to myself. I hope to continue to enforce and enact these traits in my daily life during my next 4 years at TCU and beyond. The first of these 3 is passion. Passion is accessible to every living being on this planet. However, harnessing that passion can be difficult at times. I have learned that it is most important to focus and invest your time, energy, and emotion into whatever makes you the happiest in life, instead of always going with the safe route. If you're miserable every day, sick of the task at hand, and just flat out tired, then all aspects of your life will become miserable. It is essential to be excited to wake up every morning, and to be excited to set out and accomplish the goals you've laid out for yourself, despite how others may perceive your situation to be. Except for the goal of trying to microwave your Pop-Tart, still in the packaging, in the microwave. Let's try not to accomplish that goal again. Passion. The second trait, belief, is key. To be 100% honest, I have struggled with this one the most. It is hard to always believe that you're capable of anything you put your mind to. But the truth is, you and I both are. I first learned this during my cross-country journey. Freshman and sophomore year, I invested so much of my time, effort, and emotion in cross-country. However, both seasons ended prematurely due to severe injury. What came next for me after these injuries? Wanting to quit, wanting to give in, and wanting to walk away. However, I knew that I couldn't. I knew from past experiences in my life that I needed to keep pushing and finish what I set out to do. Junior year, I ended my season at the UIL Cross Country State Championships in Round Rock, Texas. That is definitely the accomplishment that I am most proud of to this day, because I pushed, pried, and fought my way through adversity to achieve my goals. We must be confident about ourselves and our abilities, because we can achieve anything we put our minds to. There are no limitations to what you and I can do. Well, I guess there might be one limitation, actually. We all know now that we can't swallow a bottle cap whole. And yes, that theory was tested in eighth grade. Belief. The last trait, integrity, is a hard one. I'll admit that. All of us are continuously put into positions that make us rethink ourselves and our decisions over and over again until we end up making the wrong one. I have now grasped the fact that we cannot give in to temptation at any given time. It is hard, but giving in is a temporary out to our long-term problems. Yes, integrity may get us screwed in life, taken advantage of, or even set back a few steps. However, these past 4 years have shown me that in the long run, integrity will get us further in life than any other trait. Integrity. If we, as the Brock High School graduating class of 2019, adopt these three traits in our daily lives, we will be unstoppable in whatever we pursue in this next chapter. Let me remind you, continuous passion, belief, and integrity. We can be the first step. We can be the change. We can be unstoppable, and we can accomplish the unthinkable. Passion, belief, and integrity. Thank you.
Thank you, Luke, very much. At this time, I'd like to welcome two very talented Brock High School students to the stage, senior Landon Hoffman and sophomore Bayla Decker. They are going to entertain us for a few minutes. They will be singing Stoney LaRue's Forever Young. So I'd like to give you Landon and Bayla.
Morning. This is also a Bob Dylan song too, Mr. Ashley.
May God bless and keep you always. May your wishes all come true. May you always do for others and let others do for you. May you build a ladder to the stars and climb on every rung. And may you stay forever young. May you grow up to be true. May you always know the truth and the light surrounding you. And may you always be courageous, stand upright and be strong. And may you stay forever. May you stay. your hands always be busy. May your feet always be swift. May you have a strong foundation when the winds are changing and shift. May your heart always be joyful. May your song always be sung, and may you stay forever young.
Well, that's not a tough act to follow there, is it? I was talking to many parents out in the foyer before we got started, and they were thinking that they wishing that y'all were staying forever young. So that's a good song for those to sing. Thank you, Bayla. Thank you, Landon, very much for not only your willingness to sing tonight, but your talents very much. At this time, we'd like to recognize several people in our audience tonight. And so I want to recognize, first of all, two young men who are prepared to serve the U.S. military. And if I, when I say their names, if you would please stand. Jaden Chancellor is looking to join the U.S. Air Force. Got to sit down. We got to do this again. And Jeffrey Cook, looking to join the U.S. Army. I want to thank you, gentlemen, for your willingness to serve, your willingness to sacrifice and serve our country. You will be in our prayers as you prepare to enter the service. Thank you very much. I'd also like to recognize the senior members of the National Honor Society. It came to my attention this week that in this past year, the senior members only of that organization have served over 945 hours of community service in the Brock community this year alone. Special thanks to those students and sponsors, Ms. Whitehead and Ms. Brunner. Thank you all very much. And a very special thank you tonight to Ms. Teresa Wilcox. Ms. Wilcox, for those of you who graduated before, formerly known as Ms. Hall, has orchestrated this graduation for several years and does an amazing job. This entire evening just doesn't happen. And we want to thank you again, Ms. Wilcox, for your efforts tonight. Those in the audience tonight, if you are an educator that at one point had these kids in class, would you please stand and remain standing for me, please? If you're an educator in this, and they're going to be standing all over here probably, a lot of them right here, some of them back there behind you. Graduates, these before you share with you this evening and are equally as excited as you are. I had the privilege myself of teaching about 3/4 of these kids in junior high. In math and algebra, and it's, guys, it's our hope that we made an impression on you in those 13 years in some way that as you leave high school, and while some of those lessons we taught maybe were redirecting or correcting at times, never ever doubt the fact that these people standing before you love you very, very much. Thank you very much, teachers. This past summer, I had a conversation with Chad Wakefield, and he offered some very wise advice that I want to share with you tonight. His challenge is, as you leave Brock, take a little piece of Brock with you. And wherever you end up, leave a little piece of Brock there. You know, this school, this community is a very, very special place. And while you may not totally realize it right now, one day soon you will. Before we invite Mr. Smith to come to the podium and begin our official certification process, folks, we still have a small window here to celebrate these graduates before they are officially alumni. So if you would, please join me in recognizing this great group of men and women, the 2019 senior class of Brock High School. Mr. Smith will be joining me now for our seniors for graduation. Will the graduates, candidates for graduation, please stand? The Brock Independent School District requires that students meet established criteria for participation in this ceremony. All students participating in this ceremony have satisfactorily completed these requirements. Mr. Smith?
I'm going to make y'all stand for just 1 second before I officially certify you. Mr. Atchley left off one person, and in the recognition, I think it's very important that we recognize someone here that definitely deserves this recognition. And it is a difficult and very prideful job to be the high school principal. And if you seniors will help me for just a moment, your high school principal, Mr. Atchley. Members of the Board of Trustees, the Brock ISD, as Superintendent of Schools, it is my distinct honor to certify that before us tonight, the Brock High School class of 2019 have met every requirement as determined by the state of Texas, the Brock Independent School District, and the Board of Trustees for high school graduation. Congratulations, graduates.
At this time, then, we will begin. If our first group of graduates will prepare to receive their diplomas. If you would stand, please.
Cooper Lee Allen. Hunter Lynn Baker. Brylan Deanne Barrett. Willow Diamond Bell. Caden Luke Benton. Matthew Thomas Blankenship. Megan Marie Bonick. Parker Lane Bounds. Cassandra Paige Boxel. Josie Lee Bradley. Hunter Devin Bramlett. John Colton Bruner. Sarah Elizabeth Bussell. Kale Davis Cadle. Lauren Astrid Chambers. Jaden Alexander Chancellor. Macy Claire Coates. Natalie Valene Conger. Brianna Monique Correa. Tristan Ray Crossland. Justin Ryan Cummins. Baylor Dean Cup. Macy Reagan Dennis. Ethan Blaine Fagley. Landry Brooke Feltz. Taylor Diane Gallegos. Joel Richard Galloway. Peyton Nicole Gaska. Tyler Heath Groves. Luke Todd Hamilton. Bethany Deanne Hazard. Ryan Allen Henderson. Caden Joshua Hendricks. Yeah! Trevor James Heron. Riley William Heron. Brandon Dean Hobbs. Braden Pace Hodge. Landon Rhett Hoffman. Preston Hunter Hughes. Richard Wayne Jones III. Jeffrey Allen Owen Cook. Alyssa Michelle Lackey. Celie Reese Ladwig. Kylie McKay Laverty. Jessica Nicole Lay. Jessica Paige Leak. Jenna Nicole Lindberg. Jace Toby Lopez. Connor Scott Luce. Austin Cole Madry. Landon Browning Matthews. Jared Thomas Matsky. Brooklyn Rayanne McCall. Demi Lachey McDaniel. Easton Scott McGee. Lacey Elizabeth McKenzie. Halston Dean McPherson. Mary Elisa Mendoza. Dylan Thomas Merrill. Emily Grace Metzler. Toby Michael Morrison. Cooper Reed Nelson. Yeah. Kate Madison Norman. Chloe Nicole O'Grady. Kendall Rose Pack. Payson Aston Parker. Sandon Kendrick Parker. Marjorie Lane Patterson. Sean Paul Peeler. Justice Orion Perkins. Sophia Tiana Pittsford. Faith Ann Plumley. Catherine Maureen Redder. Eliza Maya Rodriguez. Chloe Lauren Rutkowski. Julio Sanchez. Havana Alexandra Santa Cruz. Jacob Thomas Shriver. Caden Blaine Skipper. Braden Matthew Smith. Skylar Lorraine Smith. Bailey Slade Sykes. Dakota Ray Taylor. Jake Allen Teske. Christopher Scott Thomas. Josie Ray Thompson. Lauren Ruth Wakefield. Ding Chen Wang. Rhett Grady West. Rihanna V. White. Anna Claire Summer Wilcox. Jaden Lene Wilson. Creighton Ray Wolf. Zach David Young.
Sit down. 2019 graduates, congratulations. At this time, the seniors of 2019 would like to honor those in their lives who have played a major role in who they are today and what they will become in the future. We've set aside a time for our rose presentations. Seniors, let's get started. Ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to thank you for allowing us to have that time. That is a special ceremony that these kids have done for years. As you can tell by their faces and the tears they're shedding, I think they enjoyed that. So thank you very much. I want to ask our graduates if they would please stand for our school song. With the Brock High School class of 2019, you may now move your tassel from the right side to the left side. Ladies and gentlemen, it's now my pleasure and honor to present to you the Brock High School class of 2019.
Don't you know which clothes even fit me?